Environmental group Oceana Philippines, meanwhile, welcomes the veto of the Bulacan Free Port Bill. For more on this, we are joined by Oceana Philippines Vice President Attorney Gloria Estenzo Ramos. Good to have you on the rundown, Attorney Ramos. Good morning.
Good morning, Stanley, and good morning to all the viewers, listeners.
Starting off with your reaction, how did you feel upon learning that President Marcos vetoed the bill creating the Bulacan Airport City Special Economic Zone? Tell us, did you see it coming?
No, frankly, it was a welcome news on a Saturday, and coming from the first president, from the new president, it's like he's exercising the much needed political will to make sure that all the laws are consistent to the one another. And of course, on the part of the environment, Oceana and our networks have long been opposed to the 21 proposed reclamation projects in Manila Bay alone and 187 all over the country. Kailan ba tayo titigil sa pagsisira sa ating lakas-yaman amidst the impacts of climate change, biodiversity crisis, and the economic crisis that we are facing? Because without nature, we cannot possibly survive. So we welcome this. This is this shows that and telling Congress that they should study the implications of bills that they are passing. We oppose the granting of legislative franchise to the Bulacan airport and the city because it destroys the mangroves, the remaining mangroves forest in Manila Bay. Likewise, there was a rider in that bill which converts the existing mangrove forest into alienable and disposable. Okay. This is inconsistent with the procedure set by law, and there was even no approval and consultations with the stakeholders and the departments concerned. Kaya maraming problema itong Bulacan Airport na ito. At sana talaga makinig tayo sa ating mga batas at sa mga ating stakeholders. Sa ating saligang batas, andyan yung constitution natin, the right to have full and balanced ecology in accord with the rhythm and harmony of nature, the rights of preferential fisher folks to their traditional fishing grounds. These are in direct collision with that reclamation project in Bulacan.
Attorney Ramos, you opposed the project, of course, on behalf of Oceana, citing grave environmental impacts on Manila Bay. Environment issues were also one of the concerns Mr. Marcos cited in the veto. Now, what basically are these issues? If you can explain to us perhaps how disadvantageous the airport project is for fishing communities around the area, and how many as far as population are we talking about?
You know, Metro Manila, Manila Bay is an interconnected ecosystems. Kung ilagyan mo yan ng project na nakakasira sa mangroves, sa fisheries, and the livelihoods of those dependent on fisheries and even farmers.
Right.
Kasi maapektado sila sa flooding na mangyayari, then it impacts the entire Metro Manila, Manila Bay. For example, there was a JICA study which showed that it's not feasible to have that airport in the area because it's subjected already to sea level rise, and Metro Manila for that matter, and the Philippines has one of the highest rate of sea level rise in the world, four or five times higher. So kailangan holistic ng approach natin, and we welcome NEDA's guidelines. They came up with a guideline together with the Philippine Statistics Authority and the Department of Environment Natural Resources, which would mainstream natural capital accounting in the accounts of government. This means putting in values to our natural world, to the marine habitats, to all terrestrial habitats, before embarking on projects that put us and make us more vulnerable to the impacts of climate change.
Okay, now Attorney Ramos, in its inception, were there any attempts by your group to appeal against the airport project, particularly with the past Duterte administration? How was your complaint handled?
We were not listened to, though I remember one of the last public statements of the president was saying no more reclamation in Manila Bay, but it's not being listened to. And Of course, he filed a case to stop the project in the Supreme Court, filed a motion for reconsideration when it dismissed the case, but we were not gaining anything. Wala, dinismiss talaga. But DILG Secretary Anyo came up with a circular reminding local government units that environmental protection is their mandate and they should follow all the safeguards required by the law, such as public consultation, and they should certify under oath that they went through all of these processes before making any approvals. And isa yung accountability ng mga local governments sa Bulacan. And we are going to ask them if they have complied with that requirement of public participation and other safeguards.
Okay, Attorney Ramos, I don't know if you consider this a total victory because the president said a veto is just the fastest way to cure the defects, which may also mean it can be refined and refiled and the airport will still be constructed. We've spoken to Bulacan Governor Daniel Fernando over the weekend and he is still confident that within or beyond the special economic zone framework, the airport project can still proceed. Your thoughts?
Well, you know, we're dealing with political departments and there's a lot of negotiations and all. I'm not going to say anything about that. Sa amin is we should prioritize environmental rights and environmental protection and the livelihoods of our coastal communities, which are really being affected by these reclamation projects all over the country and in Manila Bay.
Okay, still on the subject of refining and curing, do you see a way of proceeding with the project and still addressing your concern? Or is it a no-go at all costs on your part?
Hindi na talaga pwede. Hindi na natin kaya. You know, there's a flooding in Malabon and Fisher Fox attribute it to the dredging, mga reclamation projects na nangyari sa Manila Bay. Let's listen to science. Embed science in our decision-making. NEDA has a study na dapat no-go na yung airport project na yan eh. Why are we not listening to science? Kailangan bang matabunan muna lahat bago titigil? Ang dami ng damages inflicted upon the lives of our fisher fox and our natural ecosystems. Tikilan na natin ito. Ayusin na natin. Isang ocean lang tayo, isang bansa lang tayo. Unahin natin how our natural life support systems and our people can be more resilient and less vulnerable to the impacts of climate change. And mangroves absorb carbon dioxide more than even terrestrial forests. Bakit hindi natin, lagyan natin ng values yung ecosystem services? And that's what NEDA is going to do. So I hope NEDA will be very much involved kung i-refile man ito, put in the values of the ecosystems that will be destroyed and are being destroyed right now, despite the law criminalizing the destruction of mangroves, patuloy pa rin yung reclamation projects na yan.
Okay, now probably a string of discussions will ensue the veto as proponents may refile a cured version of the bill soon. Is your group ready to raise your position and how may you improve it? The Supreme Court, as you've mentioned at the height of your case filed years ago against the project, found it insufficient in form. Now, don't you think it takes more than just a writ of kalikasan perhaps to strengthen your position?
Yes, kailangan na community-based engagement. Ipakita ng mga tao na ayaw nila itong mga proyekto na ito. And we have been successful in deterring projects. Siguro kailangan na unified na rin yung ating mga kababayan and the president will listen to them. That's my call. The institutions have not been very satisfactory in the response to the issues of climate crisis we are facing, biodiversity crisis, well-being of our people. But ipakita na natin, we saw that volunteerism during the campaign. Let's bring that back on and fight for our survival. Survival issue ito eh.
All right. Lastly, Attorney Ramos, SMC, the project's franchise operator, also assured the public that it will address the environmental issues and proceed with the plans with sustainability in mind. Do you find this reassuring?
No. There are projects. Well, I don't want to say anymore. Action speaks louder than words. So yan yung sabihin ko. It's so easy to say something and do the opposite. Kaya hindi ako magsasalita tungkol dyan.
All right. On that note, thanks a lot for joining us, Attorney Ramos. Good morning.
Thank you very much.